Yeye monja. Yeye monja.
In the luminous city, bare backs with a gilpin cutlass between elbows, sweat oozing from his solar capital like government.
Ye monja guide me. Ye monja.
He was my age then, and he wore beige bell bottoms over Tanahas suede desert boots, overstepping streets and tree lined boulevards in search of the carnival. But there were no masqueraders on the avenues, no brass bands, no bamboo, no wrist, no rubber, no steel, no color. The city seemed ghostly bare, so he asked the dust. He says, "Where is the carnival?" And the dust replies, "Many things begin and end in the sea." That was the day a black rain fell, bucketed drop and rivers rose over mountains. The storm sent shacks tumbling, the sky dim lit like a dream. Many skulls were bust just by the weight of raindrops. Milligan ran to the high cliffs on the coast and found that many had already flown east from there. They left burning heaps of bed linen, dried fish in chamber pots of mud and manjack bitumen, and the bones of those the spirits refused flight. Milligan saw the water coming over the hill, flinging wooden beast like sorrow self, and seeing this broke him bare. The suffer the love bore thick tears in his eyes. But you see, my Milligan, he was a black heart man, never fearful. He unlaced his boots, he removed the sterling silvers, then he bent his head in meditation at that steep brim between the gulf and the sea-swept hills. He had saved many lungs of breath by then. In a sack he hid under his armpit, and so he just up and leapt into the sea below. Movement that grows, movement that flows, movement that flows as your life goes. Start to swim, so he swim with Slink and Mountain Chicken. Milligan swim with Zanji Eel and Pushaman fleeing the island. He strung alone under swirling tides. And early on the fifth day, he met a merman. And he asked the merman, he said, "Mr. Man, where my Airi?" And the merman replied, "Airi dissolved in the flood like sugar in saliva. Only fragments remain." "And Africa?" Milligan asked. And to this, the merman calmly replied, man with a merman to the outskirts of an undersea kingdom. He had heard about this place from the Baptist mythic. He had heard the pearlfisher's rum talk. But its dimensions had long been underestimated by even eminent cartographers. Milligan saw the black coral caves. He saw the intricate emblems stitched in bone. He saw hummingfish dart between his oar and personal temple. And on the outskirts, he could see the volcano plantation, spewing magma and pumice flame from the seabed. And he saw that when the molten stone dried, crests and valleys were formed, and within these were crystalline segues and some aquatic chambers where his people lived. Milligan asked the merman, and the merman said, "Many things begin and end with the sea. Indeed, the earth is hollow, not solid as was thought." And such as these were the words that kept Milligan in Ulukun's kingdom, till soon he would not notice water, and we never saw him again.
Above the sun.